This is a video on histograms. The question states, the data shows the number of times last year that respondents ate at fast food restaurants. Sketch a histogram using six class intervals. So here's our data, and we can see that there were a couple people that didn't eat at fast food restaurants at all last year. And then someone who ate it 12 times, and then the whole spectrum all the way up to this person who ate at fast food restaurants 200 times. We want to create a histogram for this data. So we start out by finding our class interval width. So the formula for the class interval width is that it's the maximum minus the minimum divided by the number of class intervals. The maximum was 200, the minimum was 0, and we're using six class intervals. So I calculated 200 minus 0 over 6, and I got 33.3. Now I always round up to find out what my width is, so my width is 34. Since my minimum value is 0, I'm going to buffer that by subtracting 0.5. so that none of the boundaries contain any of the data points. So my very first boundary is from negative 0.5. I add 34 and I get 33.5. My next boundary, if I add 34 to 33.5, I get 67.5. So I'm going to go from 33.5 to 67.5. And then I keep it up. I keep adding 34 each time. And I get the rest of my class boundaries. The last one is from 169.5 to 203.5. Notice that the highest or the maximum number is contained in that last interval, and that's important. It always should be. So now let's compute our frequencies. So we go to our data and we count how many values are between negative 0.5 and 33.5. And zero is certainly in between those. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And 35 is not in that interval. So there are 12 for that frequency. Okay, then I count from 33.5 to 67.5. And I arrived at 26. And then I got 13 for the next interval, and 2 for the next interval, 1 for the next, and then my interval from 169.5 to 203.5, that 190 and 200 were in that interval, and that's it, so there's two of them. Notice I'm creating a frequency histogram. Had I wanted a relative frequency histogram, I would divide each of these numbers by the total number of data points, which happens to be 56. But since I want a frequency histogram, I use frequency values. So those frequency values will help us in scaling our axes. The largest number we want is 26, and we're going from 1 to 26. So I'm going to go up to 30, and that should contain all of our frequency values. And here's our histogram. Notice I went up to 30. I counted by fives. It's a little prettier that way. And here's my intervals from negative 0.5 to 33.5, and I have a rectangle of height 12. From 33.5 to 67.5, I have a rectangle of height 26. Then I draw the next rectangle of height 13, then 2, and then 1, and then 2 again. So here's my histogram. Notice that it's unimodal. In this second bar is the mode. And it is basically skewed to the right because from the mode, there's a lot more data to the right than there is to the left. It kind of tails out to the right. And I'm done with the problem.